In this video, we'll look at how to chart daylight hours using sunrise and sunset data. This is the final chart we'll be building. Let's look at the available data. You can see we have data for both sunrise and sunset. Both columns contain valid Excel times. Now, if I try to create a column chart with just this data, we'll have some problems. The clustered column option isn't really useful. Stacked columns are closer to what we want. But if you look closely, you can see that both sunrise and sunset are plotted as durations instead of starting points, which isn't going to work. There are several ways to approach this. Personally, I like to use helper columns, since helper columns let you work directly on the worksheet with formulas, and you can work step by step. First, we need a column for total daylight hours. This is pretty simple. I can just subtract sunrise from sunset. Both values are times, so the result can also be formatted as time. However, I don't want AM/PM, just hours and minutes. Now I can create a chart with daylight hours stacked on sunrise times. Notice I'm not plotting the sunset data. To add hours between sunset and midnight, I need another helper column for evening hours. The formula is simple, but the concept is a little tricky. Excel time is recorded as fractions of a day. Because there are 24 hours in a day, 1 hour is the same as 1 over 24. And 24 hours is 24 over 24, or 1. This means I can subtract the sunset time from 1 to get evening hours between sunset and midnight. When I add these hours as another data series, we have a readable chart. Now I just need to tidy things up. First, I'll give the chart a title, delete the legend, and adjust colors. Then I'll bump up the column width and add data labels to show total daylight hours directly on the chart. Next, I'll format the vertical axis to line up on the clock. 3 hours in Excel is 3 over 24, or 0.125. If I set max to 1 for 24 hours and use 0.125 as the major unit, the axis shows 3 hour increments. I can use number formatting to show hours only. Finally, I can make the daylight hours easier to read by converting to decimal values in another helper column. The formula is just 24 times the daylight hours. Back in the chart, I'll change the data labels to show these new decimal hours. And now we have our final chart.